YouTube friends and YouTube family, I guess. So if you guys saw, I am wearing this 30-day cardiac event monitor. The reason for that, if you go back and watch, my cardiologist wanted to make sure that there was nothing like structurally going on with my heart, and I'm kind of on like a health and healing journey right now. And just a really quick recap, this all started a couple years ago when I started to get like body zaps and stuff, and specifically after I was weightlifting. And it's taken this long to get a referral to a cardiologist for a 30-day monitor. And that is the furnace in the background. I'm in my childhood home today. Well, actually, I'm in my childhood home right now until we leave in January, because we are traveling full-time and we're about ready to head down south. And we kind of just are staying with my dad and my stepmom until we head out. So if there's any weird noise in the background, this thing will shut off. It'll just take a second. So the update I'm giving you today is because this monitor just beeped. Guys, the weightlifting did it. So if you can see on the bottom there, it says that one. So this thing, I can push a button to like self-record an event. It just recorded one on its own, which means I either got an irregular heartbeat, I could have had like a slight arrhythmia or something. So the weightlifting set it off. And self-recorded an incident, and I'll tell you what that means. So going back a little bit, the cardiologist wanted me to wear this 30-day monitor and to kind of do the activities that were triggering my heart episodes. So in high school, if you guys saw that, I was diagnosed with neurocardiogenic syncope. And long story short, over the past couple of years, I have been having these episodes where I couldn't go up the side of a mountain. Altitude was affecting me. I don't know why. I'm sure there were other stressors at that time in my life too, like being a single mom, having a newborn, going through a really messy divorce, like. So there were some emotional stressors, so I don't know, because I never had a problem before with elevation or airplanes. When I went onto an airplane, it felt like my heart was like gonna stop beating, and it was quite honestly terrifying. 2 years ago, I haven't been on an airplane since. and I noticed that when I was, you know, I'm a former personal trainer, and I now own and run my own virtual wellness studio and online fitness challenges, but I'd been gaining weight and I couldn't do weightlifting workouts because I would get these like zaps. I'd get zaps when I was falling asleep. I'd get these incidents during the day where my heart would just start to flip-flop, and it was really frustrating because I love weightlifting. So my cardiologist thought it would be a good idea for me to go on this event monitor and go back to weightlifting just to see what would happen. So today I started my weight program. So I don't work out in a gym. I used to work out in a gym, but obviously with traveling full-time, I needed something that fit my lifestyle. And as a mom, I don't always have access to a gym. And what the heck is going on with my face? I'm like breaking out. So anyways, I do my workout online on here. I have on-demand fitness. So, and if you're curious about on-demand fitness, or you're like, that sounds intriguing, I'll put a link down below to what I use. I actually have a 14-day free like trial code to give to you, and I'll explain that. If you click the link, it'll take you to the page, explain everything, and show you how to set it up. But anyways, I did my on-demand fitness workout today with weights, and then I started to feel a little funny. Like, my feet almost start to get real cold and kind of sweaty and feel like they're not getting enough circulation is the best way to describe that. And I stood up and I noticed I was kind of shaky, a little dizzy. So I was like, okay, take some deep breaths. I'm gonna have a little shake here and go back to my workout, and I did. And then I was standing by the stove over here getting ready to cook my breakfast up, and my monitor started going off. So I can either press this button. The difference between this event monitor and like the other ones is that sometimes you have to push the button to actually record it, and if you miss it, you're kind of out of luck. This thing will record constantly. So it's always recording my heart rates and rhythms at all times. And I can either push this button down myself and, you know, manually record something along with the symptoms I'm experiencing, or if it detects an irregular something like a rate, a rhythm, like something a little off, it'll record it itself. And the only times it self-recorded were when I was in line at the grocery store and got a little stressed out after 5 hours in the car with three kids. That I thought was kind of funny, because then it started and then it just did it right now. So I had just completed my workout, not even 10 minutes later, and the thing starts recording, and then it transmitted it itself. Which it does. Like this thing, I think it's every hour. I could be wrong, but I think it's every hour it'll send those events in a special report. And it's basically its own built-in cell phone. Like this thing transmits data, which I don't love. Like I don't love wearing a cell phone device at all times around me, but it's only 30 days. So there was that. I'll keep you guys posted. I mean, obviously I don't know what they're going to find or what's going on, but I'm just letting you know that that happened after I weightlifted. So we'll see. And I guess it makes me a little nervous. Like, what if this is, you know, and I know that's not the right way to think, you know, I be positive, but part of me wonders, like, am I ever going to be able to, like, weightlift normally? Is this just going to be how life is? And then the other side of my brain is like, well, what could possibly be causing this? Because I didn't have this before. It makes me wonder if this is all linked to that monovirus I had, EBV, which can mess up a whole bunch of things in your body. I highly recommend, if you guys have ever heard of the book, or if you haven't, get your hands on the book Thyroid Healing or Medical Medium. The book was recommended to me, and it explained like 98% of everything I've been experiencing in my body could be linked back to when I had the monovirus. So it just makes me wonder, like, is this just a side effect with my heart of, you know, that virus still being in my body, or is this separate? Is this like structural something? I guess I don't really know. So there's that. I'm just giving you an update on what's going on. Yeah, like I said in, I think, yesterday's video, my sleep study is in a week. So the goal for the sleep study, it's not that they think there's anything wrong, like sleep apnea. They're going to check. They want to see how weightlifting affects when I fall asleep. So I get these things where like my heart will flip-flop and almost like ka-thunk, I guess, or like it feels like, and then when I stand up, it feels like things like get stuck, and then I kind of black out a little bit and it goes away and it's fine. So I don't know, you guys. The reason they want to do the sleep study is so they can put the wires on my scalp and see what's happening with my brain waves, if it's like a brainwave heart connection. So I'm praying that if there's something to find, that this weightlifting thing will continue to trigger that and they can catch it. Or I'm praying that it's just gonna go away on its own as I continue to heal. So we will see. Anyways, I'm gonna go finish my breakfast, which happens to be soup, because I've been craving soup like crazy. And I've been posting daily behind the scenes updates on my Instagram stories, if you like Instagram. If you prefer Facebook, my Instagram stories link to my Facebook, which is my public Facebook page, and I'll put the links down below. So thanks for coming along. I will continue to post updates as I have them. Oh, there's Christopher. You're supposed to be doing homework. Go back, do your homework. He came to say hi. He's doing school right now, which is cool, because I don't know, maybe if you've just been following my health updates, you don't know this, but we decided that we were going to homeschool, and you guys, it's been the best decision, and it's going so awesome, and the kids are finally like thriving with school, and he's like accelerated, which is great. So there's that. Thanks for coming along. This is a bonus update. This is not a regularly scheduled video. My regular videos are Monday, Wednesday, Friday by 11 a.m. So I'm still gonna post a video for tomorrow. Be sure, if you're new here or you're just finding this, I'd love to know where you're from. How you stumbled upon the video, feel free to put that in the comments. Or just say, hey, I check the comments a couple times a week. And be sure to hit subscribe with the little bell thing, because I figured out that that bell, when I post a video, it won't annoyingly notify you like a Facebook notification. It'll just come down on the screen and be like, oh, hey, Sarah posted a new video or update or whatever, if you care about that. So, all right, I will see you guys later. I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye.